Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I am so excited and delighted to come to you from our headquarters here in New Life Ministries. Ladies and gentlemen, in a moment from now, we shall soon be getting into the sanctuary to join to this service. We again want you to know that we are on YouTube, we are on Facebook, we are Message TV, and you can catch us live from any of these platforms. But I want you to know today, your life will never be the same. As we begin to worship God, as we begin to honor God, connect yourself and your life will never be the same. I welcome you to the service. This morning, let's look at Genesis chapter 37, verse 1 to 5 as our foundational text. Our foundational text will come from Genesis 37, 1 to 5. After 2, please, it's on the screen. 1, 2. And Jacob dwelt in the land wherein his father was a stranger, in the land of Canaan. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock with his brethren. And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and with the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives. And Joseph brought unto his father their evil report. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was the son of his old age, and he made him a coat of many colors. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably unto him. Verse 5, and Joseph dreamt a dream, and he told it his brethren, and they hated him yet more. Spirit of the living God, come and speak to our hearts.
Yes, Lord.
Send supernatural wisdom, conviction, persuasion, and let your name be glorified in Jesus' name. And the church say,
amen.
Can you please take your seats? I want to take a few minutes and speak on a subject I have called God's dark room technology. God's dark room technology. Can we say it together? God's dark room technology. One more time, please. God's dark room technology.
Wow.
I know those who are maybe 30 years down may not be conscious of this technology.
Yes, sir.
But some of us remember that in photography, there's what they call dark room.
Yes, sir.
Dark room. In those days, before the emergence of digital photography that we use today, where they just swap and you can see your picture, in those days, when they take our picture, especially in the days of Jimmy Photo Studio, Ademola Photo Studio, those where they can take 5 minutes to get your focus. Okay, make you Etsu. We had one cameraman. When he would take time, then he would come out. Okay. And you will see this man. And after they take the pictures, they carry it to a place they call a dark room. In this dark room, they use some chemical that they use to process the picture. The important thing is, in this dark room, light must not penetrate prematurely. If light penetrates, the picture they blot.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Light's not for the day. If for the room for dark in a prescribed specific way.
Yes, sir.
And for a particular period, and get it time, then they time them when they don't make everything, close all the curtain at the wall, then put them at the chemical, then they time them. And at a particular time, specific, then go pull them. And wave and sow. Let breeze blow. And blow. Yes. I said, wave and sow. And wave and after the breeze don't blow. And look at when you see him, you see a beautiful picture. You will never see the trace of darkness upon that picture.
Yes,
what
sir.
You are going to see is this beautiful picture.
Yes,
and
sir.
We will rejoice. Yes. That's how we used to do. In fact, in those days, when we take picture, they take 1 week.
Oh, yes. Yes,
so then it take 2 weeks for Lekida and Bringer. Because what you do, the cameraman, the chemical way they use, it there for them. So if now you want to take it, they wait till you don't take 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 other people.
Yeah.
So that when they use that one chemical, they go to watch Boku picture. Yeah. So you got for wait.
Yeah.
All things don't change now. Digitalization has changed life.
Oh, yes.
Yes, sir.
And I think the principles will be the same, it's just that it has been modernized. Because what they used to do analog way, now it happens digitally. But for the picture to become a picture, I'm sure technologically it goes through a dark room. Can I?
Oh, yes.
Am I making sense?
Yes,
yes
sir.
Sir.
Yes,
sir. As I meditated on this process, I came to realize that our God also has a dark room
yes, sir.
Technology.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He uses a dark room technology to process us.
Oh.
Just like the picture is processed in that dark room and comes out as a beautiful image and
yes,
everybody
sir.
Admire. When God wants to process our life, when God sees a life, when God sees a potential, when God sees a personality and God has a great plan for that person, he takes him to some dark room process.
Yes, sir. Hallelujah. Yes, sir.
Somebody got the revelation. Give Jesus a praise.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord.
It's the Lord.
My God.
Today I'm just teaching. This is not the message that makes you jump up. But I want you to listen.
Yes, sir.
Because I'm teaching.
Closer.
One of the Dakum technology process that God employs, one of the reasons that he takes us to dark room is to bring out what we call brokenness. Somebody say brokenness.
Brokenness.
Please talk to me, church. Join
brokenness.
Me.
Brokenness.
One more time.
Brokenness.
Brokenness. Brokenness. To be broken in life is to get to that point where you are not defensive, over defensive, fighting and making fuss with everybody for one thing or another. God is so break you that even what you need to be mad about, surprisingly, you don't mad. That's brokenness. Can somebody say brokenness?
Brokenness.
When God has a plan for a life, but he realizes that this personality or this person has a terrible character flaw which will not help him to fulfill destiny and to fulfill purpose, it takes you to the dark room.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, the dark room represents issues.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I am telling you this so that I want to be balanced. I've been telling you about the devil for the last 5 weeks. But I want you to come to the point to understand and be balanced as a believer. Yes, the devil has a place, but it is not every negative thing that happens come from the devil. Sometimes it's a dark room experience.
Yes, sir, it is.
Somebody's a dark room.
Dark room.
We read the text we read is from Genesis chapter 37. And we head 1 to 5, and I want to make a few references. Now, brokenness is to reduce you, to make you humble. If you are proud, if you are arrogant, if you are full of conceit, God humbles you. There are two words It's either you allow God to humble you, and if you refuse to be humble, he will humiliate you.
Hey, Lord have mercy.
So I would rather agree to be humbled than to be humiliated.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Am I saying something?
Yes, sir.
In this life you are living as a born-again Christian, some of the foolishness, arrogance, pride, attitude that some of us have, it will open us if we do not change and change on time. As long as God has a plan for you, if you do not humble yourself, you will be humiliated.
Lord,
and that's why I'm warning you. Talk to me, somebody. In the text, 37:1-2, please, media. Genesis chapter 37. And the Bible says, and Jacob dwelt in the land wherein his father was a stranger, in the land of Canaan. Verse 2. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years. In fact, I have a problem. There were 12 sons. Joseph was the 11th of those 12 sons. Why did he make a reference to the first, or the second, or the third, or the fourth? Do you know why? Because in divine destiny, there was a plan that was so big, and this guy was going to be part of that plan. The Holy Ghost singled him out.
Yes, sir.
Because he was not fitting to the plan. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, he was feeding the flock with his brethren. And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and with the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives. And Joseph brought unto together, let's read that last clause. And Joseph brought unto his father
their evil report.
Why does the Holy Ghost single that last character trait? Joseph brought to his father. Why didn't he say Reuben? Why didn't he say Levi? Why didn't he say Manasseh? Why did he zero? Joseph brought unto his father their evil report. It means this was not a normal thing. It means Joseph had this character weakness to become oversensitive to his brothers and to his sisters, to the point that every little thing he comes to lay report.
My God.
Am I talking?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
That was a character flaw. Oversensitive, over defensive, always looking for fault from the others, as if he too never made mistake. And when he comes home, he takes care of the father's flock. But when he comes home, that did this one, I saw he do. And the Holy Ghost pinpointed that character flaw. So number one, we want to see, as we study Joseph, we are beginning to see one of the reasons why he will have to go through the dark room.
Yes, sir.
Because he had a character flaw.
Yes.
If he was a man who God would use in the future to do great things and to help other people, he cannot carry on with his stupid character.
Oh, God.
And that's why I am afraid for some of you women in the women's ministry, men in the men's ministry, young people in the young people's ministry. And sometimes the way you behave is like you are the only one who has a problem. You have a problem with the president. You have a problem with the vice president. You have a problem with your brother. You have a problem with your sister. It's like you are the only one. Check it out. If you don't change, God will send you to the dark room.
My God.
And when I begin to tell you about how the dark room looks, you will understand. Am I talking?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Don't be silent on me.
Flow, sir.
Flow with me like a kid.
Yes, sir. We are getting you.
Eh?
Flow, daddy, flow.
We are getting you.
Very powerful message, sir.
The dark room process. Speak.
Let's go to verse 3. Media, let's go to verse 3. Flash it in the... Now Israel loved Joseph more than
all
his children, because he was the son of his old age, and he made him a coat
of many colors.
My God.
When you study the life of Joseph, of Jacob, you find out that he married two wives. One was called Leah, the other was called Rachel. He didn't want to marry Leah, but the father-in-law played tricks. And when they got married, the Bible says Leah had cross eye. And God sorry for him. He opened it in womb, he make him begin born, begin him. Rachel, she became barren. And in those days, your mate, the wife's mate, if she feels, just like Sarah gave, what's her name? Agar to Abraham. If the wife feels she can give her maid to the husband. So even Zilpha and Bilhah were impregnated. When she saw that, she herself gave a maid. So well, at least we go myself now me begin. And they don't born before one day Jacob cried unto God. Then God opened the womb of Rachel. And that's how she gave birth to Joseph and Benjamin. Later that. So Rachel, when they born Benjamin, died from the childbirth. So all the love, because for Rachel, that man they woke 14 years, because originally, yes, now before 7 years for Rachel, yes, but sir, then get a wrong wife, Leah. So he woke another 7 years. So forget him, 14 years. So when she died, all that love, he passed it to Joseph, the first picky way born for her. So when did they see Joseph? Now, Rachel did they see. And so the Bible says, Israel loved Joseph more than all his children because he was the son of his old age, and he made him a coat of many color. Ladies and gentlemen, again, the second flaw, character flaw, is that by this statement, we know Joseph was a spoiled child. Mm. Talk to me.
Yes, sir.
A spoiled child.
Yes, sir.
That means the papa no bring her up like inner papa, he bring her up like inner grandpa. Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. Yes.
In his old age. And then he made a coat
of many colors.
He showed Joseph safe and they all. Now you are like,
yes, sir,
which was dangerous. He made a coat for him. And so Joseph became a spoiled child. So we begin to understand why this attention where Joseph they get make it they always come for can lay complaint to him papa. So now he no more in papa go leg because he was enjoying it.
Yes, sir.
Am I talking?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He was enjoying it. That was the second problem, second flaw in the life of Joseph. Give me verse 4. Let me show you some. Give me verse 4. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably with him.
My God.
There is something they call sibling rivalry. How many of you are acquainted with that word? How about a sibling rivalry?
Sibling rivalry.
Any mama and papa know say, as long as you get more than two picking at us, they can jealous themselves, they can fret themselves, they can make unnecessary arguments.
Yes, sir.
If you put them behind your car, you they drive, you go hear them there for some funny thing that they argue behind they this no not to you for do you know what I mean? They call them sibling
rivalry.
That's what it's called. Sibling rivalry. That means the children are jealous of each other. They make fuss with each other. They fight each other. Whether it makes sense or it doesn't make sense. But they do. Come on, media, don't take it out. Don't take it out. And say, and when his brethren saw. So the error of Jacob was that he was not supposed to let his children, the other children, see that he loved Joseph more than them. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him more. Yes, your papa begin. This is important for every parent who still have kids who are coming up, So watch this. Be careful that you don't sell your children to each other. Yes. There is uniqueness for every child.
Yes, sir.
And every child, when they are around, should be treated with equality. And then if you want to show some extra love, you can show it. I remember the year that Leonard Bonke came, and he said, he was in the conference and he was telling us a story. He said his mother, he had another brother, a younger brother or older brother, I don't remember. But he said every time when he see a brother come with sweets or biscuits, it vex. So when he vex, you know the taco, it go to him up in a corner, it just make him face. So one day, your mama can't say, I'm missing them. I say, Reynard, say, Mom, why are you vexed? Say, Mommy, you have given toffee to my brother. You didn't give to me. Then the mother said, your brother asked me. That's why I gave it to him. If you want, ask for your own. I will also give you. Don't get vexed. What are you getting mad for? I will give you. That sibling rivalry. He could have asked his mother. His mother would have. But just because he sees in brother they eat, he vexed. You may be shocked that our children will behave just that same way.
Very correct, sir.
So if you're a parent who have little kids and they are still coming up,
yes,
please watch out. Watch out that you don't manifest it, because it can bring mortal hatred,
yes,
amongst the children in the family. Talk,
yes,
to
sir.
Me, somebody.
Yes, sir.
So I think Jacob made a mistake when he showed all of the sons. He said, and when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak. There is something they call Oedipus syndrome. Oedipus syndrome. Not so soon. And Oedipus syndrome says a girl child is dominantly attracted to their father. And male children are attracted
to their mother.
Have you seen that?
Yes, sir.
It's normal. It's called Oedipus syndrome.
Yes, sir.
And sometimes even this normally causes a problem, because if all of the children, if you have three girls, and even, do you know that in the early years of blessings, we sat in the dining table, we were talking something, and she backed me up. Mommy cried. Say, yeah, you see, now you know more they listen to, now you know more they talk for. And she cried.
Yes, sir.
Because it was very serious to her at that point. No, you know they do that again. Now get me tell now, and mommy tell me again. So these are realities that we have to deal with. Talk to me, somebody.
Yes, sir.
Yes, am I making sense?
Realities, yes, sir.
All right. So there was sibling rivalry already. That's also had character problem with Joseph.
Yes.
Can I go? Can
yes,
I go on?
Yes, sir.
All right. Give me verse 5.
And Joseph,
in the midst of these character flaws,
yes,
Joseph dreamt a dream, and he told it his brethren, and they hated him yet.
The more.
Everybody said lack of wisdom.
Lack of wisdom.
He was 17 years old. He was a youth. I thought it would have been good for him to share that dream with his daddy. And after I shared that dream with his daddy would have told him, okay, no worry, I will think about her. But he tell him brothers, on top of what you papa don't do to we, on top of the thing where yourself they do, they go only we complain. They can't tell we say you dream, we all they bow to you.
Disaster.
Listen, church. Then Creole they say, dog dream.
Left
nine belly. If Joseph born come back, he will not share, if he dreams, he will not share that dream.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Be careful with the people who you share your vision, your dream, your plans, your blessings. Yes, be careful. Yes, because it's not everybody that you share these things that are happy for you. Sometimes when you are sharing, they act like they are smiling, but they are not.
Yes, oh, yes.
Because they say, now you good thing for happen to every time.
Wisdom.
In the early years of New Life, as soon as God shares something, because I am a loyal friend, and yes, I have a friend. And so as soon as God shares something for me for do, when I talk to any of my friends on a telephone, I would tell them, God says so. And then I will find out the very thing they don't do one before me. So it happened once, twice. So one day I was talking on the phone. As I begin, my mommy come, he look me. He not talk, just the look me. Now catch up.
Yes, sir.
Wisdom. And from then I learned not some things, wait for God's time.
Yes, sir.
Don't talk about it. Pray about it.
Amen.
Don't try to impress anybody by the things that God has shared with you. Am I saying something to someone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Pray about it.
That is 7:5. And Joseph dreamt a dream, and he told his dream. In this dream, he said, they all planted corn, but all of their corns were bowing to the corns that he planted. How? It's lack of wisdom. Don't be unwise. When you know who that you they share with, if you know sure of certain people, even those of you who work in offices, be careful. Because if you don't know who you are sharing with, it can be dangerous.
Wisdom.
Verse 9, please. And he dreamt yet another dream and told it his brethren. Not to his father. To his brethren. And said, behold, I have a dream. I have dreamt a dream more. And behold, the sun, the moon, and the 11 stars made obeisance to me. He had 11 brothers. He has a mother. He has a father, sun and moon and 11 brothers. So he will say, this time, not only what you planted, even papa himself and mama, they bowed to me. The mother was dead. Maybe it's a spirit. Am I making sense?
Yes, sir.
Say lack of wisdom.
Lack of wisdom.
Don't talk what God has put in your heart to everybody.
Amen. Yes, sir.
Amen.
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 And so, now God in his wisdom had looked at Joseph and felt he had the character to be the savior in the family.
Yes, sir.
The cutting tree.
Oh, yes.
In God looked from Reuben, Levi, all kind of, he realized that now Joseph in one use. So even then one year, when them get badat, for do things and hate and jealous them brother, God not do the nothing. The one way he get planned for, the one way they dream them good dream when a God put them same dream them.
Yes, sir.
Now he sentenced to dark room. So that is why sometimes you say, well, I not been believe in if I didn't see anything that happened to me. But now you are a child of God. You are a covenant child. There is a great plan that God has for you.
Amen.
There is a great plan that God has for your destiny.
Yes,
so
sir.
He can sentence you to dark room in order to make you align.
Amen.
You are not talking to me.
Yes, sir.
Can you give me verse 28? So the 37:28. Then there passed by Midianite merchantmen, and they do. Can you go back to verse 20 to 24? Come now, therefore. Now Joseph was going to them carrying food. Come now, therefore, and let us slay him. What did they say?
Kill him.
Let us what?
Slay him.
To kill him.
Yes, sir.
All right, and cast him into some
pit.
Talk to me. Some beats. Again?
Some beats.
Talk to me.
Some beats.
A pit is a grave.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And some, maybe some destiny that is seated here by witchcraft manipulation, by occult manipulation, may have been cast into some pit. Maybe they put your picture. Maybe they put something because they are fighting you. They hate you. They're envious of you. They have placed something in a pit or in a grave in order to manipulate your destiny. I stand as God's servant this morning.
Amen.
Any man, any woman whose life, whose soul, whose picture, whose image has been placed inside the pit, inside the grave to manipulate their life,
amen,
I curse them by fire.
Amen.
I judge them by fire.
Amen.
I scatter them by fire.
Amen.
I retrieve your picture.
Yes.
I retrieve your image. I retrieve
Jesus.
Your books.
Amen.
I retrieve your certificate.
Amen.
I retrieve what belongs to you.
Amen.
Come out, my fire.
Come out.
In the name of Jesus. Jesus.
Amen.
They put him in a pit. They sit up. Sit up. Let's walk it out. That's one of the easiest way to carry out their evil manipulation. They put people on the pit. This man, they shine too much. This woman, they shine too much. Let me lock her inside hole. Any pit that you have been placed, I call you to come forth.
Amen.
As Goliath came forth from that grave, come out in the name of
Amen.
Jesus. Come forth from that pit.
Amen.
Come forth from that pit.
Amen.
And enter no more.
Amen.
Enter no more. Enter no more.
Amen.
Somebody shout in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Sit down, please.
Thank you, Lord. Yes. Out of the pit.
And it came to pass. Okay, come now, therefore. Let us slay him and cast him into some pit.
And we will say,
let us slay him. Come now, therefore. Let us what?
Slay him.
What's another word for slay?
To kill.
To kill him. And cast him into some pit.
Yes,
to kill him and to cast him into the pit is their evil intention.
Yes,
you are not talking to me.
Yes, sir.
It's their evil intention.
Yes,
you are seated under the sound of my voice. Any evil intention pertaining to your life,
amen,
pertaining to your destiny, every satanic intention that
Jesus.
They have, any satanic, demonic, wicked intention for your destiny,
yes,
is
sir.
Terminated by fire.
Amen.
It is canceled by fire.
Amen.
It is terminated by fire
in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Their intention will not stand.
Amen.
It will not come to pass.
In the name of
it
Jesus.
Shall not stand.
Amen.
It shall not come to pass.
Amen.
Every wicked intention,
yes,
to involve you,
yes,
unnecessarily,
Lord.
Any wicked intention,
yes,
to manipulate your life,
yes,
any wicked intention,
yes,
to give you problems in,
yes,
life,
Lord.
Cancel by fire.
Amen.
We cancel by fire.
Amen.
We cancel by fire.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Do you remember when Peter, when Paul and Silas were arrested in Acts chapter 6, no, in Acts chapter 11, it was Paul that was arrested. They had killed James, and now they arrested Paul. And the Herod intended to kill him after Easter.
Yes, sir.
They intended. There are always evil intentions of witches and wizards. Some belong to part of our extended families. Some belong to people who we are close to, who we work with, who we interact with. They have evil intention.
Yes, sir.
They mad. The way you carry yourself, the way,
yes,
you,
sir,
dress, the way you speak, the way you walk,
yes,
they,
sir,
are mad about it, and because of that they have
evil intention.
Yes, sir.
So when you pray, learn to take authority and dominion over any evil intention.
Yes, sir.
Somebody is not hearing me.
Oh, yes.
As if somebody is not hearing me.
Yes, sir.
Any demonic intention,
yes,
that has been programmed into the realms,
amen,
to manifest in this year,
in
2022,
Jesus,
it shall not manifest.
Amen.
I say it shall not manifest.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We sanctified the rest of the months. September, October, November,
yes,
December.
Amen.
No satanic intention concerning your life, concerning your destiny,
yes,
concerning your family, concerning your future, concerning your profession.
Oh, yes.
In the name of Jesus, it shall not stand. Neither shall it come to pass.
Amen.
Somebody shout amen 3 times.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Please take your seat. Come now, therefore, let us slay him and cast him into some pit, and we will say some evil beast has devoured him, and we shall see what will become of his dreams. How many of you have dreams?
Yes, sir.
How many of you have dreams?
Yes, sir.
Stand to your feet. Raise your right hand. Say, my father, my fighter.
My father, my fighter.
This day, I dedicate.
I dedicate.
I sanctify.
I sanctify.
I consecrate.
I consecrate.
My dreams.
My dreams.
With the blood of Jesus.
With the blood of Jesus.
I dedicate.
I dedicate.
I sanctify.
I sanctify.
I consecrate.
I consecrate.
All of my dreams.
All of my dreams.
With the blood of Jesus.
With the blood of Jesus.
My dreams.
My dreams
shall come to pass.
Shall come to pass.
My dreams.
My dreams
shall start.
Shall start.
It shall come to pass.
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 It shall stand.
It shall stand.
Say, oh my father.
Oh my father.
Every one of my dreams.
Every one of my dreams.
That is supposed to manifest.
That is supposed to manifest.
Before this year comes to an end.
Before this year comes to an end.
Oh my dreams.
Oh my dreams.
Manifest by the hand of God.
Manifest by the hand of God.
Shout amen 3 times.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Verse 21, please. And Reuben had it, and they delivered him out of their hands and said, let us not kill him. May God raise somebody who will stand for you.
Amen.
Verse 22. And Reuben said unto them, shed no blood, but cast him into this pit that is in the wilderness. And lay no hand upon him, that he might lead him out of their hands later, to deliver him to his father again. That was his own plan. Reuben is the eldest brother, and he knows that if they go home without their brother, it is him that his father will hold accountable. So he was trying to put him here, leave him. Then he will plan to come and remove him.
Amen.
Now this is what I want you to know. When you are destined for a dark room, even when good people have good intention for you, God will frustrate it.
Yes, amen.
Lord, am I talking?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is a man where God don't give dreams, say, go be this, go be this, go be this. Yet, they want kill him. In water, one rescue him. But God did not permit it. Give me 23. And it came to pass, when Joseph was come unto his brethren, that they stripped Joseph out of his coat, his coat of many colors that was on him. Verse 24. And they took him and cast him into a pit, and the pit was empty. There was no water. Go to 23 again. And it came to pass, let's read it together, 1, 2. And it came to pass, when Joseph was come unto his brethren, that they stripped Joseph out of his coat, his coat of many colors
that was on him.
The coat represents garment. Many times when you dream nakedness, or you dream you wear cherry clothes, or you dream you just stand up in a public place, so you know for the, it means they have attacked your garment.
Yes, sir.
Am I talking?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It
yes,
means
sir.
They have attacked your garment.
Yes,
they want to attack your garment. Since you wear, that's not your garment. That church clothes, not to your garment. That lapa, not to your garment.
Yes,
that aftertowel, not to your garment.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I receive mine. I take it.
And therefore, any man or woman,
amen,
who is under the sound of my voice,
yes, sir,
whose garment has been interfered with,
yes, sir,
in the name of Jesus,
amen,
I call forth and restore your garment.
Amen.
I recover and restore.
Amen.
I recover and restore.
Amen.
Your garments are restored.
I receive
in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Garment of beauty.
Yes, amen.
Garment of excellence.
I receive, yes,
garment of greatness.
I receive it
in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
May your garment be restored.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not live here without your garment.
Amen.
Somebody say, I receive.
I receive.
I receive.
I receive.
I receive. I receive.
In the name of Jesus.
Please take your seats.
I receive.
Thank you, Jesus.
God permitted him to enter the dark room. Verse 28, please. 28. Then there passed by Midianites merchant men, and they drew and lifted up Joseph out of the pit, and sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites for 20 pieces of silver, and they brought Joseph into Egypt. They sold him. This from a favorite son in his father's house to a despised slave. Sold. Sometimes we check our life. Things can change some way we don't understand. The way we want for like things be, you know, be so. It's either two things. If the devil, you bind him and cast him. But if it is God, you say, God, let your will be done. The quicker you submit, the quicker the process.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Talk to me, somebody.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
There was Reuben. There was this other two brothers, Levi. And
yes, sir.
Simeon and Levi, who went to kill people and brought blood into their father's house, and the anger in their lives. Why did not God call them and send them to dark room? It has to do with the plan. Listen to me now, believers. We all not are the same.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So when you did at church, you see something that happened to your sister, or something that happened to your brother, Lefa, you concentrate on what God they do for you.
Yes, sir.
Because on a different. The thing where God want to do for you is different from what God
want to do for the other,
person. My God.
Yes, sir.
Are you seeing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You're getting used
to it. In the book of 1 Corinthians, Paul says, in the heavenlies, every star is different from the other. Every star. And if we are stars, so if you look up, you see some stars, they shine. You see some stars, they glow. You see some stars look big. We all, they shine differently.
Differently, sir. Differently.
That is why you commit a crime if you're just jealous of your brother or your sister because of what they happen to her. You are a fool.
My God.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
When you get jealous of your brother, your sister, what did happen to them? You are a fool.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I made up my mind that if I hear good things about other servants of God, I will celebrate it.
Amen.
That is why you will never see me come to this pulpit and begin to preach about men. No, 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 no. I have too much word of God to preach about men.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Glory.
There are men of God, they go to their pulpit and they take 30 minutes talking about other men of God.
My God.
They don't have sermons. Am I making sense?
Yes,
you
sir.
Are.
Because I know who I am in the Lord. He has made me this way.
Yes,
and
sir.
You must know who you are and you walk with God in that way. Talk to me, somebody.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Two, sir.
I want to do so in a choir. The day when you come and sing fine, celebrate and
yes, sir.
Yes, yes, sir.
Appreciate him.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Praise him.
Yes, sir.
Oh, come on, say, I'm a diabo. Na anything, Nandi. We all can do it. Na lie. Happy for him.
Yes,
then
sir.
God go give you self. You talk to me, somebody.
Amen.
I hear you, sir.
Hallelujah.
I hear you, sir.
God allowed him to enter into the dark room.
Amen.
They sold him. They put him in the pit. Dark room experience number one. They sold him into slavery. Dark room experience. Number two, as I speak, there may be some people already experiencing some dark rooms. Take courage and be sure, because Dakum experience can expire.
Oh yes.
You didn't hear what I said.
It has an expiry date.
Yes, it can expire. And I pray for you that your date will not be delayed.
Amen.
Any man or woman who is going through any dark hole, your date will not be delayed.
Amen.
It shall expire when it should expire.
In the name of Jesus.
If I'm making sense, say amen.
Amen.
Give me verse 36.
Thank you, Jesus.
It says, sit down, please, sit down. I'm teaching. I told you this morning, I want to teach. And the Midianites sold him into Egypt unto Potiphar, an officer of Pharaoh's and captain of the guard. So first, in order they sell him a slave, then the Midianites, they said, go make profit, they sell him. Say, Dakum.
Dakum.
It's Dakum experience.
Yes, sir.
That's the Dakum experience. From a favorite son in his father's house, sold into slavery. That is Dakum experience. Genesis 39 verse 10. Chapter 39 verse 10. And it came to pass, as she spoke to Joseph day by day, that is Mrs. Potiphar. She spoke to Joseph day by day, that he hearkened not unto her to lie by her or to be with her. In your dark room experience, you're going to go through some tests.
Yes, sir.
Talk to me.
Yes, sir.
Talk to me.
I hear you, sir.
God is going to... You see, one of the dark room experiences is test.
Yes, sir.
Abraham is called father of faith. He was the one who the whole Jews nation was going to come by, and yet God tested him.
Yes, sir.
And while he was in his dark room experience, this test was granted to him. Now, if while he was in that dark room, he yielded to the devil and failed the test, it will be prolonged.
Yes, sir.
My God.
It will be prolonged.
Yes, sir.
The Dakum experience will be prolonged.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Now, watch this. The Bible says the woman tormented him day
by day
after day. Mm-hmm. Every day she was tormenting him. Every day. Be careful. When the devil have set you up, they will come after you on a regular basis. They want you to disobey God. They want you to mess up with God. They want you to yield to temptation. Listen to me. They don't love you. Be careful.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes.
I hear you, sir.
Day by day. Thank you. Am I making sense to somebody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Day after day. Don't give up.
Don't give up.
Don't mess up.
Don't mess up.
Give me chapter 39, verse 20. And Joseph's master took him and put him into the prison. The Dakum, they get worse. Did you see it?
Yes, sir.
And so sometimes you say in my life, after everything just unbug, it's not always Satan. Please understand this.
Yes, sir.
Pray and let God reveal to you. And Joseph's master took him and put him into the prison, a place where the king's prisoners were bound. And he was there in the prison. From slavery, now to prisoner.
Hey.
Daku. And yet God don't show and say, God forbid, big man. God forbid, big this, if we get this. And yet, he was having Daku. Listen, any preacher, where only they tell the people them, say, God, he's not going to make you suffer. He's not going to make you do this. It's deceiving you. You only have to be a believer for 1 or 2 years for let you able to say, even though you're a believer, sometimes challenges will come.
Yes, sir. True, sir.
Am I talking to someone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. There is the prophetic aspect we declare with faith and know that God is able to do things. But when God's hand is upon you for a reason,
yes, sir.
You can fast, you can pray, you can walk, you can bind.
Mm-hmm.
His hand will take you through.
Through the process.
Talk to me, somebody.
Hallelujah. Yes, sir.
Now, deliverance comes in two ways. either deliver from or deliver through. If it is not God, if it's the devil, you'll be delivered from.
Yes,
sir.
But if it's a dark room, you'll be delivered through.
You'll go through it.
That's why he said, we go through the fire, we go through the water. Talk to me.
Yes, sir.
But guess what? If it's the hand of God, you will never be destroyed.
No, it will look like
you are going down, you are going down, you are going down. But suddenly you will bounce back, and every eye shall see and know that you serve
the living God.
Hallelujah.
Give me chapter 40, verse 23. 40, 23. I want to show you, I'm showing you dark room experience. Maybe I'll continue next week. And she conceived and bare, 40, 23.
Yet
did not the chief butler remember Joseph, but forgot him. You remember the story when they dreamt, the chief butler and the baker dreamt the same night, and they came, and Joseph was the one that God used to interpret. He told the baker, you are not going to be restored, you will be killed. He told the butler, you, the king, in 3 days' time, the king will call you, he will restore you to your job, exactly as he prophesied. That was what happened. And when they sent to call the butler from the prison, say, the king has restored you, he said, you should come. He turned to Joseph, and Joseph said, well, remember me? Mean na lie the life I'm you, I not support for dinner. So when you go talk for me, let them go pull me. You would think that. So that's what like old Joseph, for the fact that he don't interpret the dream for him. He owe him.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. You would think that the first 1 week after he restore, he go bring Joseph in him.
Oh yes.
Look at what the Bible said. Yet did not the chief butler remember Joseph. He forgot him. Ladies and gentlemen, don't tell me the man was wicked. This was God
at work. Yes, sir.
I'm telling you. So let me say this to some of you. If you reach now some spot, you see people that will not forget you. It seems as if they are not looking at you. It seems as if they are not remembering you. Go back to God.
Yes, sir.
Go to God. Yes, sir.
Sometimes I tell you the truth and I lie not. God will cause people, when he wants to take the glory, he will cause people to forget you.
Oh yes.
When we were building this building, a particular prominent personality came to visit this church, and he told us that once he has come, he's going to help and to build this church and give us money. And we were happy, the building committee was happy, and after some time, they put me under pressure that you should try to go talk to him and remind him. I said, no, I'm not going to remind him, whatever happens. I said, and I didn't remind him. But after the pressure, I said, I don't want many people to feel like for say, well, I'm too proud. And I went. And I reminded him. And he said, oh, dear, text me in 2 weeks' time. Text me. And I text him in 2 weeks' time. And he never responded. And I waited for another 2 weeks. I text him back. And he never responded. And that was the end. He had forgotten me. But guess what? I am thanking God today.
Hallelujah.
Because maybe, therefore, calling an anti-corruption.
Hey.
For say then give me government money.
Lord have mercy.
Are you seeing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
So let God handle some things. Hey. Let God handle
let God
it.
Handle
let
something.
Man forget me,
oh, yes.
Or let God remember me.
God
I said, let man forget me.
Yes.
Let God remember me. The Lord will remember you.
Amen.
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 Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Remember me,
Lord. He will remember you.
Amen.
Yes. He will remember me.
God will remember you.
Amen.
Remember me, Lord.
Let men forget. Sit down, please. I'm almost done for today. Give me chapter 45, verse 5. Now, remember, when I begin the story about the character of Joseph, remember I say, they bring a complaint.
They complain.
Yes,
sir.
small-minded guy, oversensitive guy, right?
Yes, sir.
Talk to me now.
Oh, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Shallow-minded guy.
Yes, sir.
Just defensive and sensitive and wanting to find, you know, feel, say, other person forgets good things. That's how he was made. Now that God has taken him to the dark room, and the picture is clear now. I want you to watch the same Joseph.
Yes,
give me chapter 45, verse 5. 45, 5. Now, this is Joseph talking. His brothers came to him, and finally he revealed himself, say, I am Joseph, the one you sold. Imagine them brother them. We sell them. They don't call Egypt. They don't say, Joseph, don't turn big man. Then Joseph can reveal himself, say, I am Joseph. Is my father alive? And what was going on in the brother's mind is, Lord, have mercy. We don't know.
Yes,
we don't know. We don't know. And when I study this passage, I begin to understand that God is really good. Listen, respect anybody where you see God in handiwork.
Yes, sir.
At the talk?
Yes, sir.
Even if you're a small sister or your small brother, you see God in handiwork. Respect them all.
Yes, sir.
Because when a member say, Reuben, go lay down with him, papa, one in woman. If now Reuben, Madam Potiphar, been go talk to, you know they talk to themselves.
Free flow.
You know they talk to themselves. So God don't bless me now. So God saw it.
Yes, sir.
Oh, now we look Simeon and Levi. We go kill for their sister because somebody messed up with their sister. Then go and kill whole city. Eliminate them. So now look, say, now they don't go Egypt. They don't turn big man. Then their brother come. Now we been sell you. Because not just they call the soldiers. Are you seeing what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
God saw something
in Joseph.
In the life of Joseph.
Yes, sir.
You know, sometimes we're so small-minded and shallow-minded. You go sit down and say, well, dear, not to preach the party, you can't preach Sunday night. We all can dwell on, not to anything. If we all take the Bible, we can preach it, we can declare it. Yes, so not to any big thing. You are a fool.
You are a fool. Oh, yes.
Do you know what God saw in me to give me the vision?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You're not talking.
You're speaking, sir.
I hear you, sir.
My God.
Jesus have mercy.
You're speaking.
Now, look at Joseph. The same Joseph now. The picture don't come out. Don't come on at that cool. Now, therefore, be not grieved, nor angry with yourselves that you sold me here. For God sent me before you to preserve life. That was Joseph talking. No, blame yourself. Now, God sent me. That's Joseph. That's Joseph. The same guy will be the report. Any small thing you see, where in Papagi, cut of many colors and things, and I'm not the only person. Is now, another member himself, he was broken.
Hallelujah.
He was broken.
Yes, sir. He was broken.
Yes.
Broken. He was humble.
He was broken. Somebody say he was broken.
He was broken.
One more time.
He was broken.
Go to verse 8. Verse 7, sorry. Go to verse 7. And God sent me before you to preserve you a posterity in the earth and to save your lives by a great
deliverance.
8. So now, it was not you that sent me here. Una no blame una self. Apula na una 8. Not to get nothing.
God.
He said, but God.
Yes, sir.
And he has made me a father to Pharaoh.
And Lord.
Lord of all.
Hallelujah.
A slave will enter Egypt. Became the father of the king of Egypt. If God's hand is upon you, Your life is going to prosper at the
Amen.
End. Your ultimate. Let them bounce you like a ball, but you will bounce back.
Amen.
You will rise to the place where
the
God desires. Talk to me, somebody.
Amen.
Give it to me, media. It says, so now it was not you that sent me here, but God. He has made me a father to Pharaoh and the Lord of all his house.
Hallelujah.
And the ruler throughout all the land of Egypt. Let me tell you something. When wokeness comes, you understand God in plan.
Yes, sir.
Why many times people not walk according to God in plan, they are not broken.
Yes, sir.
When you preach, then they can choose what thing they believe. They are not broken.
Yes, sir.
So they can't understand God's ultimate plan. The Bible says, let your kingdom come, let your will be done. Talk to me, somebody.
Yes, sir.
And so if you don't go through some dark room experience so that your eyes will open.
Let the scales fall off our eyes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Let's take your seats. I'm almost there. Verse 7. Yeah, verse 8. So now it was not you. Go to the next verse. Hasty, go up to my father. Say unto him, thus saith thy son Joseph, God has made me Lord of all Egypt. Come down unto me and tarry not. You will be beneficial to your generation.
Amen.
You will be beneficial to your family.
Amen.
You will be beneficial to your time.
Amen.
You will serve your generation.
Amen.
You will not die until you serve your generation.
Amen.
Whatever God has predestined for you,
Amen.
It shall come to pass.
Amen.
They may sell you
Amen.
As a slave.
Amen.
They may get mad with you.
Yes,
they may
Lord.
Get envious with you.
Amen.
But ultimately,
Amen.
You will become a benefactor.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Did you hear? Amen. You will become a benefactor.
In the name Amen. Of Jesus.
You did not hear me. You will become a benefactor.
Amen.
You will become
Baba
a benefactor.
Amen.
You will become a benefactor.
In the name of Jesus.
You bless your generation.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Everybody stand. Let me close for today.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Bless the Lord of my soul.
Yes, Lord.
Now watch this. Any of you women who have been fasting for 3 days, if you want to sit while I'm talking, I have no problem, you can sit. But if you can, stay up and connect to me. Now, Joseph has gone through the dark room. And because he successfully went through the dark room, he became Lord of Egypt. A great man, an enviable position. But he suffered. And he took it graciously.
Yes, sir.
I want to pray for some people this morning. You are not going to come out. I'm going to pray for you while you're in your seat. Because it's dangerous if God takes you to the dark room and they try to speak to you, but you're not conscious and you fight against whose eye don't put you. Revelation is for redemption.
I hear you, sir.
Anytime God sends his word, he sends it to heal his people.
Oh,
he sends it to challenge his people.
Yes, sir.
I don't know you, but God knows you. Some of you, you are at the neck of your dark room. And God wants you to understand that you are at the neck and that the next thing that will happen to you will surprise many people.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
And I pray for you that nothing will delay your movement from the dark room into the celebrated position. Nothing will delay you. Nothing will distract you. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Sometimes he wants you to serve him. He's waiting for you. Serve him in a better way. He wants you to have a revelation of who he is. If you don't have tangible reason not to be absent from church, you should not be absent. If you don't have tangible reason to do something every week for God, you should not mess up.
Yes, sir.
Because you will prolong your dark home.
Yes, sir.
If there is any man or woman, you have been sentenced to that dark room and demonic powers have come inside now to lengthen your experience, to make it look like God is not there for you, I raise my voice as an apostle of God unto heaven today.
Amen.
And ask for the expiration of your dark room.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Any power that is involved, any demonic power involved in your dark room experience,
yes,
let them be terminated.
In the name of Jesus.
By the authority of heaven.
Amen.
As I raise my voice on this altar and cry on your behalf,
yes,
I command you to graduate in the name of Jesus.
Name of
graduate
Jesus.
From your dark room.
Yes, Lord.
I say graduate.
Name. Amen.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Hey. In the name of Jesus.
Graduate. Graduate from your dark room. Any rope, any chain that they have held before you, that you will not come out, you will stay in that problem, you will stay in that intimidation, you will stay in that calamity. Right now, by the fire of God, I consume that chain, I consume that rope, I terminate it in the name of Jesus. May the hand of God,
amen,
rest upon you.
Amen.
For signs and for wonders.
Amen.
For signs and for wonders.
Amen.
For signs and for wonders.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I surrender. I surrender. I surrender. To thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender. Commit your children into your hands.
Yes, Lord.
Let this week,
yes, Lord,
be a week of a momentous joy and happiness.
Amen.
Lord, as you show me all of the letters,
yes, Lord,
coming down, envelopes coming down, and people are receiving the envelope with joy,
yes,
they are opening it and celebrating.
Amen.
So let it be in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This very week, may their testimonies be perfected.
Amen.
Let some of their testimonies begin this week.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Let's share the grace.
The grace of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
And the love of God. And the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Rest, remain, and abide with us all.
Now and forevermore.
Amen.
God bless you. Tuesday, we're in the state of war continues. Don't miss it.
Holiness.
Well, praise the Lord. I'm sure today you have been blessed by today. today's service and the word that God has sent to you. My prayer for you is that every revelation that you have received will become a revolution in your life. Once again, thank you for joining us in today's broadcast. Join us again next Sunday, same time on YouTube, Facebook, or on Mercy TV. You can always get us, and please join us every time. God bless you.